So how would all of you like to send kids to summer camp without leaving their home? Well, thanks to a unique partnership between Metro Parent and the Michigan Science Center, you can do just that. So joining me are Michelle Leroy with the Science Center. Thank you for being here.
Yeah, no problem.
And our friend Kim Covell with Metro Parent back in the house. And we cannot forget about Izzy. Hi, Izzy.
Hello.
She's with us and she helps kids with the camp. So Kim, let's start with you. Why don't you just explain to us how the program works?
Yeah, for sure. This is our second year doing this, and we're really excited to bring it back. It is a totally free camp for kids, all online. You can do it at your leisure is how it's set up, because it's every other week is when we drop a new craft. Our first one just came out on Friday. So basically how it works is it's 12 weeks, and every other week we drop a new experiment that we do. There's a video that you watch first, and then there's a guide that you download that shows you how to do it, and there's a little more information about the science behind it. And then finally, we take a quiz, and when you take that quiz, you could win some prizes.
Very cool. So, Michelle, you and Izzy actually help families walk through these experiments, right?
That's right.
How does that work? Are you in the video?
I am. I do a different one, but we have a bunch of our educators at the Michigan Science Center, and they all take you through step by step how to actually do it at home.
All right. Well, speaking of step by step, we've got some stuff out here. What are we making today?
Well, our first experiment is a DIY fidget spinner, right? So everybody loves the fidget spinners right now, and they're really super cool. And the best thing about them is there is some actual science behind them.
Okay.
So we're going to actually make one of them today using just a lot of household items.
All right.
So we have things like toothpicks you'll need, some pennies, it's good use for your pennies, random cereal boxes or whatever, and some scissors. The cool thing about it is you'll get a little pattern, and you're going to draw out your pattern. So you would take a couple, I already drew out a pattern here, and you would just make two sides of this pattern and two pennies.
Okay.
And what we do is we can use hot glue today. But
love
you can use
some hot glue.
Right? You can use some regular glue. So I went ahead and I put the two sides together so you can see that they're nice like that. So here
to
you
keep
can
it interesting, you did the colorful sides.
Exactly,
so we,
exactly. That's from a
interesting.
Very happy Eggo box.
Cool.
And then you would take your push pin and make little holes in the middle, because that is where our toothpick's gonna go. Now, with a regular spinner, it spins a lot, right, Izzy?
Yes.
And it moves really fast. Now this is because of a particular kind of motion. Do you remember what it was called?
Angular momentum.
Exactly, so angular momentum. So inertia means that we're going to, things move forward unless acted upon by an outside force. And because this is centered around something, it's called angular momentum, so it moves
angular
in a circle.
Momentum. I'm feeling smarter already.
Right?
This is good.
But the best part about it is it has what's called a ball bearing in it, so it helps reduce friction. And friction is what makes things slow down. So we're going to create a hole, which we already did here for us.
Press.
So you're going to take a toothpick here.
Thank you.
And this is going to act as our ball bearing.
Okay.
Right? So we're going to put the toothpick through, going to squeeze it in just a little bit, and then you're going to wiggle it around because we need to make room.
Okay. All right.
So that less surface actually touches the toothpick.
Less friction.
Less friction. Exactly. There you go. And then the two circle cutouts that you had.
Thank you.
You're going to put one on each side. So just poke one on one side.
Alrighty.
And bring
it
down.
Do I want to push the toothpick halfway through? Or?
You can, yep.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
And we'll do one on the other side here. So bring those down. Same thing. So I like to leave a little bit of space so that my spinner has some room to actually go. Now, what you would do next is take a pair of scissors and you would cut off the toothpicks, but for the sake of the cameraman, I already have this done.
Okay.
So right here is the next step. I'll trade out with you. And what you do is you would glue these little circle pieces on the ends here, because the toothpick, you know, is a little rough. So right now we can actually spin the spinner, right? So it's a little piece of cardboard. And it actually goes.
This is cool.
Yeah, but it doesn't last very long.
Okay.
Right? So and conservation of angular momentum needs weight. Inertia needs weight. So anything that has mass has inertia. So we're going to add some weight by using the pennies that we have right here.
Okay.
So all we have to do is put a dab of glue on each of the little things on that.
Got it.
And we always promote safety first.
Exactly.
Yeah, thank you, Izzy.
Now, Izzy, what does it mean to make everything nice and even?
Oh, symmetry.
That's right. And you want to keep everything nice and symmetrical.
Right.
So, yep, you get one on each of them, right?
All right.
And now you should be able to spin it even better.
Look at that. I can feel the difference. This is so cool. So Kim, tell us where everybody can get more information on this.
Yeah, most definitely. So the video and the guide where we have a template for you guys to cut out also so you can make your own is at metroparent.com/sciencecamp. And I mentioned earlier that you take a quiz at the end. It's pretty simple, 5 questions. Every single kid who takes a quiz gets a general admission pass to Michigan Science Center, as well as its new engineering theater. So that's good all the way from mid-September to late December. So that's one thing. And then out of all those kids, one lucky winner is going to get $1,000 for college.
What more could you ask for? Kim, Michelle, and Izzy, thank you guys so much for hanging out with us. Guys, over to you.